Among the countless tales of courage in the Indian Army, the story of Lance Naik Mohannath Goswami of 9 Para Special Forces is legendary. This is a story the Army regards not just with pride, but also with a sense of awe and disbelief. This is a story of a commando who volunteered for 3 operations, 10 days straight, killing 11 terrorists in all. The warrior had been home for his daughter's 7th year birthday. It was a complete 2 weeks of rest before he took his final train to Udhampur in Jammu and Kashmir. Barely a week after his return to Kashmir, the warrior had to set off on the first of his final 3 operations. Operation Khurmur. Captain Deepesh Mehra and his team were fighting 3 terrorists in a village called Khurmur. Meanwhile, Mohannath Goswami and a senior officer Major Anurag Kumar, along with 4 commandos, were heading towards a nearby village where the intelligence had reported the presence of 10 terrorists. They were just 20 minutes away from this contact spot when they received a message from Mehra's team in the communication set, saying, "Mehra saab ko goli lagi hai." Mohannath Goswami immediately asserted, saying, "Saab, Mehra saab ghayal ho gaye hai, hum turant wahi pe chalte hai." So this team decides to go for the rescue of Mehra's team. The terrorists spotted this approaching vehicle and opened fire at them. The commandos jumped out of the vehicle, took safety cover positions and started firing at the terrorists. In the first few minutes of the encounter, Mohan was successful in killing one of the terrorists and evacuating Captain Deepesh Mehra out of danger. By morning, 2 more terrorists were killed and Operation Khurmur was declared successful. This team barely rested for 2 days when they received fresh inputs from the intelligence. It said, 4 terrorists have crossed the Shamsabari mountain range and were heading towards the Baramulla sector. 12 of India's most hardened warriors were selected to hunt down these 4 terrorists. Operation Lida Panjal. The 12 commandos were airlifted and dropped off 4 kilometers away from the last known location of these terrorists. Mohannath Goswami spotted the footprints of these terrorists and said, "Sir, isi taraf se gaya hai, hame contact zarur milegi." So this team started to follow the footprints of these terrorists. By then, the army drone pilot also confirms that the 4 terrorists were hiding inside a cave. The team fired 2 grenades into the cave, which forced 2 out of the 4 terrorists to come out. Mohannath Goswami, with his favorite single shot mode, fired just 2 rounds, killing them. His senior officer recalls that any man in such a situation would fire in a burst mode, because they want to be extra sure. But Mohan fired just 2 rounds. He was that confident of his skills. So in the encounter, Mohan was successful in killing the 3rd terrorist also. He calls out for the 4th terrorist to surrender. He said, "Bhaijan, abhi bhi mauka hai, ab surrender kar do. Kyun aaye ho yahan pe marne ke liye?" So this 4th terrorist with no heart left to fight surrenders. Operation Lida Panjal is a victory now. Just 2 days after Operation Lida Panjal, this team receives fresh inputs from the intelligence. The intelligence was solid. 6 terrorists have crossed the line of control and were hiding in Suchalyar forest of Kupwara district. It is one of the densest forests in Jammu and Kashmir. Indian Army plans a 96 hours long operation with 6 squads of 36 men. Mohannath Goswami's team spotted the 6 terrorists and opens fire at them. Since it was midnight, it became even more difficult to hunt down these terrorists. The terrorists fired 2 grenades from the underbarrel grenade launcher. The splinters from these explosives wounded 2 commandos who were lying just a few meters away from Mohannath Goswami. He knew exactly what he had to do. If there was one impulse stronger than killing terrorists, then it was Mohannath Goswami's need to evacuate an injured comrade in an encounter. So he jumped out of his cover position, firing furiously at the terrorists. Regardless of his wounds and personal safety, he kept charging at the terrorists. Mohannath Goswami was hit by 2 bullets, out of which 1 bullet pierced through his waist. The warrior crashed onto the ground, but not before killing 2 terrorists and injuring 2 more. Mohannath Goswami made supreme sacrifice in the highest traditions of Indian Army. At this moment, India lost one of our finest fighters. For his courage and bravery, Mohannath Goswami was posthumously awarded the Ashok Chakra, India's highest peacetime gallantry award. Mohannath Goswami's courage, determination, willpower, his valor, and above all, the love for his country is honorable. The nation salutes you, sir. Jai Hind.